Your voice, your opinion, your community. Fact TV, free speech protected.
It says that there's going to be a Memorial Day parade this weekend. Oh, I think we should go. We've got a flag, and oh, I've got a patriotic scarf on, and oh, look, I could wear my patriot hat. What's that? Stick with the scarf? You don't think I should wear the hat? Oh, hello there. Welcome to Grandma Kitty's house, and I'm Grandma Kitty. I was just reading the paper, and there's going to be a Memorial Day parade this weekend, and I was going to wear my hat, but Sergeant Fluffy here, he thinks I should just stick with the scarf. Oh, I just love a parade, don't you? Yes. You know, Memorial Day parades, they're not usually very long, no, but you know, I like to go see them, and I bring my grandchildren sometimes, and we wave our flags. I might need to get some more flags to make sure I have one for each grandchild. Yeah, but, oh, I do love to go to parades. And Memorial Day, we're celebrating America, because America is a wonderful country. Yes, it is. Oh, speaking of that, I have a story here that I wanted to share with you. Oh, this is a book about America. And, oh, let's read it and see just what a great country we have. So, this is God Bless America. It's a Zonder Kids book, and it was illustrated by Peter Francis. So let's read that together, shall we? Oh, we got to start with the first page, Grandma Kitty. As the golden sun rises and birds chirp outside, Henry leaps out of bed, his eyes open wide. There's no time to waste. Today's a big day. This bear's off to see the grand USA. Henry's bag is all packed, barely gets out the door, and now he is ready to discover and explore. Looking out his car window, everything is new. What sights will he see? What things will he do? And the sign says, "You are now leaving Bear Island." Soon Henry arrives, New York, his first stop, where he climbs way up to the top. Lady Liberty, a symbol of freedom for all, standing out in the harbor, a welcome so tall. So here he is at the top of the Statue of Liberty. Next, South Dakota, to see four famous men, one good with a sword, one good with a pen. The third from the left is young Theodore, and last is Abe Lincoln, who led us through war. Now off to see Florida's rivers and trees, with panthers and crocs and gray manatees. The Everglades is a most beautiful park, but never go swimming in there after dark, because it's got alligators and crocodiles. Remember the Alamo, Henry cries out. In Texas, he's learning what that's all about. The brave Texans fought for 13 days straight, freedom from Mexico for that great big state. Now Hollywood, California, where all the stars go, and Henry would sure love to be in a show, but when he arrives, he's feeling quite beat. So rather than acting, he just takes a seat. Last but not least is the National Mall in Washington, D.C., with monuments tall. Leaders and heroes are all honored here by millions of people who visit each year. Before Henry leaves each spot, there's a store to buy books, maps, and hats, souvenirs galore. Then he hops in the car, his trip's at an end. Soon Henry will be back in his cozy den, and his car is packed full of souvenirs. Oh, looks like he had a good trip. Now home, all unpacked, he gets ready for bed. Henry folds his paws. Thank you, God, Henry said, for the mountains and trees, for freedom so true. God bless America, the red, white, and blue. And he's got a lot of red, white, and blue in his room. Oh, isn't that a nice story? Yeah. So have you ever been to any of the places he went to? The Statue of Liberty, if you're lucky, you can climb right up to the top. Not everybody can, but if you can climb You can go all the way up to the crown, and it's a spiral staircase all the way to the top. I'll tell you, by the time you get to the top, you're kind of dizzy from going round and round. But right here in the crown, those are windows, and you can look out the windows. That's pretty neat. Oh, and then in South Dakota, there's Mount Rushmore with four of the presidents carved right in stone. And oh, Florida just has a lot to see. All the animals, the crocodiles and the flamingos and the manatees. And oh, and Texas is a big state, a very big state. It's hard to see everything in Texas because it's such a big state. And then California way out on the West Coast, and then Washington, D.C. way out on the East Coast. And oh, in Washington, D.C., they have all the monuments that are so nice to see. And there's the Washington Monument, the big tall one, and then the Lincoln Memorial, the Jefferson Memorial, the White House where the president lives, and the Capitol, and oh, just so much to see in Washington, D.C. So America is just such a beautiful country. Yeah. So, you know, there's a lot of states that weren't mentioned here either. But, oh, I'm just so thankful that we live in America, aren't you? And we have our freedom. Yeah. So I thought today we could talk about Memorial Day. So what it is and why we celebrate it. Do you know what it was originally called? It was originally called Decoration Day. Do you know why? Because they would decorate the graves. Yeah, they would put flowers and wreaths and flags on the graves of the soldiers that died in the war. It started back in the Civil War days because there were a lot of people that died in the Civil War. So they started decorating their graves. And they at first called it Decoration Day. It started, the first time was May 30th of 1868. That was a long time ago. And then New York was the first state to call it a legal holiday, and that was in 1873. And then it took almost 100 years before it was accepted across the whole country. But finally, in 1971, Congress said that the last Monday in May would be the day we would celebrate Memorial Day. So there's a couple of holidays that we celebrate for our country. There's Memorial Day and 4th of July and Veterans Day. So 4th of July is when we celebrate our independence because we became independent and we're not ruled by another country, so we're free to make our own choices. And then Veterans Day in November is when you celebrate all the men and women who have served in the military for our country, like in the Army or the Navy or the Air Force or the Marines. But Memorial Day, now that's the day when you remember those who died in service, those who died serving our country. So now here's something I didn't know. There's something called the National Moment of Remembrance. And at 3 o'clock in the afternoon on every Memorial Day, you're supposed to pause for a minute and just think about all the people who have died fighting for our country and for our freedom. I've never done that before. I didn't know that. But yeah, the whole country is just supposed to pause for a moment. So we'll have to try to remember that at 3 o'clock on Memorial Day. Yeah. So you know, there's a lot of brave men and women that fought to protect our country because they believed that our way of life was worth fighting for. Yeah, and I agree with them. I like the way we live in America, where we're free to choose what we want to be when we grow up, or where we live, or where we go, or be like Henry, travel across the country. Yeah, so let me tell you about putting flags on the graves. Now, my grandsons were in Boy Scouts for a while, and we helped with that. And so they have flag holders beside the soldiers, and there's a star on them, and that's how you know which one to put a flag on. But let me tell you about this huge cemetery. There's probably more flags there than you could count. Yes, it's a cemetery that's called Arlington Cemetery. It's a national cemetery. It's just outside Washington, D.C., and it's not the largest cemetery in America, but it is definitely big. And what's so amazing about this cemetery is that all the stones are the same size. They're white marble gravestones, and they're all lined up in nice, neat rows. So it's row after row after row of white marble graves. Do you know how many soldiers are buried there? About, oh, let me show you. There's about 400,000, that's a lot, huh? I don't know if I could count that high, 400,000. And they have about 28 funerals a day, so they're always adding more. But let me tell you a little bit about Arlington Cemetery. It was established in 1864 during the Civil War because they needed someplace to bury their soldiers. And here's something that's interesting. It was actually confiscated from Robert E. Lee's family. And do you know what confiscate means? That means they took it. It was taken away from them. Do you know why it was taken away from them? They didn't pay their taxes. Oh my goodness, you gotta pay taxes, right? Yeah. So when they took it, it was just a big estate. It had Robert E. Lee's house there, and it was just lots of land and fields. And so they turned the land into the cemetery part, and Robert E. Lee's house is still there, and you can actually tour it. By the way, did you know that Robert E. Lee was related to George Washington? What's that? Who's Robert E. Lee? Well, he was a Confederate general. Yeah, he became well known during the Civil War. And you do know who George Washington is, right? Yes, he was our first president. Yes, yes. Well, Robert E. Lee married the granddaughter of John Park Curtis. And you probably don't know who he is, do you? He was George Washington's stepson. Yeah, so Martha Washington, she was married before and she had children with her first marriage, and then her husband died, and so she was left with these children to raise by herself, and then she met George Washington and married him. So the Curtis children became George Washington's stepchildren. Yeah, so that's a little bit of interesting history, huh? So anyway, back to Arlington. There's a lot of people that go to Arlington Cemetery to tour. I mean, even if you don't know somebody who's buried there, it's really very interesting to see. Yeah, the army takes care of it, and there's soldiers that are called the Old Guard, and they're the ones that put the flags on every grave, all 400,000 of them, right before Memorial Day, and it's called Flags In. So when they put the flags in, that's what it's called, Operation Flags In. Yeah, I bet that takes a long time, huh, to put 400,000 flags out. Oh my goodness, but I bet it must look incredible to see all those white stones with all the red, white, and blue flags in front of them. I wish I had a picture to show you, but maybe Mom or Dad can Google it for you. Yeah, so it's spelled like this, Arlington Cemetery. I did Google it and saw some pictures, and it's really very interesting. Yeah, so let me tell you something else about Arlington Cemetery. There's something there called the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. Yes, and so this is where they have a tomb to honor all the soldiers who died in war, but nobody knows who they were. What's that? Why would a soldier be unknown? Oh, well, for one thing, war is a rough thing. Yeah, yeah. When you go to war, you're not guaranteed to come home in one piece. No, no. I mean, nowadays, soldiers wear tags, and that has their name and all their information on it, so that if they die in the war, they can be identified. But, you know, in previous wars, they didn't do that. But sometimes they knew that it was a soldier that died in the war, but they couldn't tell who it was. And I mean, their life was important because they died serving their country. So they wanted to honor them. So they built this tomb for the unknown soldier. Yeah. And now here's something I didn't know. This tomb is guarded all the time, 24/7, 365 days a year, always. Yeah. So you know what that means? That means in the middle of the night when it's really dark and most people are sleeping, somebody's guarding that tomb. Yeah, yeah. And in a rainstorm or even a thunderstorm, yeah, somebody's guarding that tomb. And in the middle of the winter when it's freezing, and even worse, in the middle of a snowstorm, somebody's guarding that tomb. Yeah, somebody is watching, marching back and forth and keeping an eye on that tomb. That's pretty dedicated, isn't it? Yeah, devotion, huh, and dedication. What's that? Why do they guard it all the time? Oh, well, to keep people from climbing on it, for one thing, and to keep people from damaging it. You know, sometimes people don't respect property, other people's property. And not only that, it shows respect for the men and women who died, who were willing to die to protect our country. Yeah, so maybe if you Google Arlington Cemetery, you can Google that too, the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, and see what you can find out about that. Yeah. Well, I think that Grandma Kitty has talked long enough now, and it's time to move on to Move and Groove. So today I brought the song Thankful because I'm very thankful for the soldiers who have worked hard to protect our country, right? They fought hard, and they still do fight hard to protect our freedoms and so we can enjoy the way we live. So remember that our hearts were made to be, and that makes them happy when we move and groove. So hop up off that couch and join me, and let's see if Grandma Kitty can get her boombox to work. Remember last time we had a little bit of trouble with it. All right, let's see if it's going to work this time. Oh, here we go. It's working. All right.
I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love Him. I just want to lift my heart in. Everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love Him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful.
Did you get up and move and groove and make your heart happy? Oh, hell, we do have a lot to be thankful for, don't we? We sure do. All right, so let's check our bee basket. Now remember that our bee bag are the things we want to be, right? The things that we can choose to be, right? And work hard at being. Oh, let's see. Oh, this is an interesting bee. Oh, I like this one. Do you want to see it? Look. It says, be patriotic, and look, it's red, white, and blue. Yeah, those are our colors for America, right? Oh, I do like this one. Yeah, do you know what it means to be patriotic? Oh, it means to express your devotion or support for your country. Yeah, so this is a good bee for today, isn't it? Yes, because we've been talking about all the soldiers that died trying to support our country. Yeah, so what are some ways that we can be patriotic and show support for our country? Let me think about this. Oh, you know, we could wear red, white, and blue. Yes. Or you could get a patriotic hat like Grandma Kitty's here and wear it to a parade or something. Yes. A lot of people have a lot of Memorial Day traditions. You know, a tradition is something that you do year after year with your family. So a lot of people have some Memorial Day traditions. When I was younger, we used to go to the beach every Memorial Day. But you know what? You know, Memorial Day is not in the summer. Summer doesn't start technically for a couple more weeks after Memorial Day. And I'll tell you, sometimes when we went to the beach, it was mighty cold. I would wrap up in a blanket or a towel to try to stay warm. Yeah, so we don't usually go to the beach anymore. Now what we do for our Memorial Day tradition We have a cookout or a barbecue in somebody's backyard, and that way, if it gets too cold, we can move our get-together into the house where it's warmer. Yeah. But you know, you could, maybe you could go to the parade or a park or something. Yeah, find some tradition of your own. You could maybe go decorate some graves. Yeah, you know, in the town where I live, they have a Memorial Day service in the middle of town, and then after the service, the school band, they make a little parade and they march up the road, and you can just join the parade and follow the band right up the middle of the road, and they go up to the cemetery, and when they get to the cemetery, the kids help put flags on the graves. So that would be a fun thing to do. Yeah, and most towns have some sort of event or parade or something special. So if they have a parade, you could get a flag and wave it at the parade. And Oh, here's a thought. You could visit a memorial. Now, we don't have big memorials around here like in Washington, D.C., you know, like the Washington Monument or the Lincoln Memorial or any of that. But most towns do have some form of memorial, some big stones set up somewhere, and they have plaques on them with names engraved of different people that have fought in the war. And so you could go find one of those and read the names, and maybe you'll find someone that's related to you. Yeah. You could do something as simple as put a flag on your house, yeah, so that shows that you're patriotic and that you support your country. A lot of, most places that have the big flagpoles, they'll lower their flag to half staff. Do you know why they do that? When you lower a flag to half staff, it shows that somebody important died. And of course, we're celebrating Memorial Day, where we're remembering all the soldiers that died during the war. So they lower the flag as in honor for those soldiers, to those soldiers that died. Yeah. So, or if you see somebody in a uniform, or you know somebody that fought in the war, you could always just tell them thank you. Yeah. So do you have any ideas of things you want to do for Memorial Day? Was that you want to put flags on the graves? Yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's a good thing. My kids used to enjoy doing that. So yeah, maybe you can help out with that. What's that? You want to go to a parade? Yeah, that would be fun. Yeah, the Memorial Day parades, like I said, they're usually short. But let me warn you, now there's something different they do at the Memorial Day parades, and that is to fire guns in a salute to the fallen soldiers. Yeah, and that can be kind of loud. Yeah, some places, if they're by a river, they'll march out onto the river and they'll fire their guns in a salute, and then they'll throw a wreath into the river. Yeah, but that gun salute can be a little bit loud and a little bit scary, just to warn you. Yeah, so we brought our dog one time, and when they fired the guns, oh, he was so scared. He was trying to climb the wall behind him to get away because it probably hurt his ears. Yeah, but as long as you know, that's probably what they're going to do, and then you'll be prepared. Yeah, I hope that you find some great ways to celebrate Memorial Day. Yeah, and I hope that the weather's nice. What's that? You want to go to the beach? Oh, well, good, yeah. I hope you do get to do that, but you might want to have a backup plan just in case, because you never know, it might be too chilly. Yeah. But okay, here's a little review for you. So what was the name of the cemetery that we talked about? What's that? Armageddon? No, not Armageddon. No, that's the end of the world. No, it was, let's see here. Arlington. You got the R part right. Arlington Cemetery. Yeah, and do you remember how many graves there are there? Do you remember? It's too high for Grandma Kitty to count. 400,000. It would take a long time to count the 400,000. Not talking about putting that many flags out. Yeah, but the old guard, they do. They put flags on every one. And do you remember what was the name of the tomb? The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, right? And how often is that guarded? That's right, all the time, yep. 24/7, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Rain, snow, sleet, or hail, nothing stops. Oh, no, sorry, that's the slogan for the mail. Nothing stops the U.S. mail. Oh, well, no matter. Someone is guarding the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier all the time. Yeah, and why do we celebrate Memorial Day? Yeah, So we can go to the beach? No, no, no. Remember, it's more than that. It's to honor and remember all the men and women who died serving our country, fighting in the war. Yeah, so it's a very important holiday. Oh, well, I do hope you have a wonderful Memorial Day. Happy Memorial Day. And thank you to all the soldiers, all the men and women who work so hard to protect our country. And I hope that you get to do some fun family traditions with your family this year. Well, remember, like Grandma Kitty always says, you take care, you stay healthy, safe, and happy, and Grandma Kitty will see you again soon. Bye-bye.